The grace of the Lord be with you all. Let us worship the Lord our God. Humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Eternal God, our Judge and Redeemer, we confess that we have tried to hide from you, for we have done wrong. We have lived for ourselves, and apart from you, we have turned from our neighbors and refused to bear the burdens of others. We have ignored the pain of the world, and we have passed by the hungry, the poor and the oppressed. In your great mercy, forgive our sins and free us from selfishness, that we may choose your will and obey your commandments. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Hear the good news. Who is in a position to condemn? Only Jesus Christ. And Christ died for us. Christ rose for us. Christ rules in power for us. Christ prays for us. Anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. The old life is gone and the new life has begun. Know that you are forgiven and be at peace. This is the good news. Let us give glory to God.
Peace to people of good will.
Let us pray to the Lord, remembering as we do to share our prayer concerns online in the chat room on YouTube or through email. There are people who wish to pray with and for you, so give us the opportunity to do that. Let's pray together. Gracious Lord, we pray for all countries whose land is scarred by war, violence, pandemic, poverty, and famine. We commend to God our own town and our state and everyone in our community here. Where there is growth in understanding and knowledge, may we gladly give thanks. Where there are grudges that are held, may they be cleared away. We lift up to you the sick, those who are weak or damaged in body or mind. Dear Lord, give them hope. We pray for families, parents and children, husbands and wives, brothers and sisters, and for all who live alone. Gracious Lord, give us all love and a sense of service to one another. Give peace to our church and give an unrest in our congregation that we may hear your call to serve you and to reach out and to invite others to come into our congregation, our fellowship, to experience the joy of our salvation we have received from Jesus Christ. These are our common concerns, and we lift them up to you in the name of Christ. And together we join our voices as one as we continue to address you as our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Using the words of Holy Scripture, let us proclaim our faith with these words. This is the good news which we received, in which we stand, and by which we are saved, if we hold it fast. That Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures. That he was buried. That he was raised on the third day. And that he appeared first to the women, then to Peter, then to the 12, and then to many faithful witnesses. We believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus Christ is the first and the last, the beginning and the end. He is our Lord and our God. Amen. Thank you. Our New Testament lesson is from Luke chapter 6, beginning with verse 20, continuing through verse 31. Let us listen to the word of the Lord. Then Jesus looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you and exclude you and revile you and defame you on the account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets. But I say to you that listen, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other as well. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you. And if anyone takes away any of your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you." This is the word of the Lord. For many years, a well-known businessman has conducted a lot of workshops and seminars and has written a lot about the way to be successful in business. And time and again, in various speeches, he has advocated revenge as a policy, the best policy. In one speech, he said, "One of the things you should do in order to succeed in business is learn to get even. If someone hits you, you got to hit them back. 5 times harder than they ever thought possible. You got to get even. Get even." Mayor Rudy Giuliani was the mayor of New York City when the terrorists flew jets into the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center. The entire nation was stunned and wanted justice, and more than justice, many of us wanted revenge. And Giuliani just spoke in the most honest terms when he said, "Revenge is not a noble sentiment, but it is a human one." And how right he was. In the Old Testament, Moses established the rule of an eye for an eye. Now, that was a radical step back then, because up until then, the law said that if you poke out a man's eye, he can poke out both of your eyes. And Moses came along and established equal and equitable justice. As Moses put it, "You shall give life for life, eye for eye, tooth for tooth, hand for hand, foot for foot, burn for burn, wound for wound, stripe for stripe." Exodus 21. Centuries later, Jesus took justice one step further. Treat people the way you want to be treated. In Matthew's gospel, Jesus said in the Sermon on the Mount, "You've heard it said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, do not resist the evildoer. But if anyone strikes you on the right cheek, turn the other also. And I say to you, love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you." Very similar to the way that Luke recorded it in our New Testament lesson. In Luke's gospel, what he does is to give you a little more instruction on how to love one's enemy. You do it by treating everyone the way you want to be treated. Now, everybody knows that phrase, "Do unto others as you would have them do unto you." It's the golden rule. It is one of the central teachings of Jesus Christ. There's an old story that's been around for decades. It's told as a joke, that is both a preacher joke and an astronomy joke. And since I'm both an astronomer and a preacher, it's perfect for me. And the story is this. Reverend George Buttrick, a renowned preacher in the mid-20th century, was attending a conference and he boarded a plane and it was on his way home. And during the flight, he began to work on his sermon. And the person sitting next to him was curious and he asked Buttrick what he was doing. And Buttrick said he was a preacher and he was working on this week's sermon. And the seatmate said, "Oh yes, religion. Do unto others as they would have, as you would have them do unto you. That's all the religion I need." And Buttrick asked the man what he did. He said, "Well, I'm an astronomer." And Buttrick said, "Ah, yes, the stars. Twinkle, twinkle, little star is all the astronomy I need." Now, the humor of that story is that religion, like that of the science of astronomy, is deep. There are no simple subjects. And religion is hard. You just can't take one line and go with it. Following Jesus is difficult. And the difficulty I have with that joke is that as I hear it, I believe that there's nothing more complex and more difficult and more challenging than that one-liner, "Do unto others as you would have them do unto you." It's a challenge that we have every day of our lives, day by day, sometimes hour by hour. Someone cuts you off on the highway, and of course you want to cut them off too, but wait a minute, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. You go home after a hard day's work, and your wife or your husband or your child or your parent says something to you, and it just cuts into your soul and sets you off, and you feel the anger rising, and a snappy, hurtful one-liner is right on the tip of your tongue. And then, wait a minute, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. A colleague at work takes advantage of you. It's a big deal, whatever the reason. You may have missed a promotion even, or lost a raise, or even gotten fired. And you ponder how you can get revenge. If someone has hurt you, you want to hurt them back. 5 times harder than they ever imagined possible. You got to get even. Get even, but wait a minute. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Giuliani said, "Revenge is not noble, but it is human." And he is so right. But our human nature is not productive. In fact, it is counterproductive. Revenge gives birth to an endless cycle of retribution. Now, we're not talking about justice here. We're talking about revenge. Justice is a matter of law and courts and right and wrong. But revenge is motivation of anger and violence and hatred. Justice can provide satisfaction. Revenge is not satisfaction at all. It just promotes a hunger for more revenge. Anne Lamott once said that revenge and getting even is like a man who drinks rat poison and then waits, expecting the rats to die. Now, against this human nature of revenge and getting even is Jesus Christ, who stands up and says, "Folks, you've got to learn how to treat other people. You treat them the way you want to be treated. You don't treat them the way they deserve to be treated. You treat them the way you want to be treated." And Jesus is teaching us something positive and creative and productive. Other religions have their equivalent of the golden rule, but it's usually expressed negatively. Hindu teachers say, "Do nothing to others which if had done to you would cause you pain." The Buddhist religion teaches, "Hurt not others with the pain that would hurt yourself." Jewish traditions and the Talmud teach, "What is hateful to you, do not do to others." Now, these are negative statements. They teach what we should not do to someone who has been bad to us. Jesus takes this a step further. It's not just avoiding doing bad things to others. It is actively doing something good to other people. do to others what you would have them do to you. Now, you see the difference? In other words, if you're cut off in traffic, it's more than just not cutting them off in traffic. It's actually doing something active and letting them merge into your lane and not giving them the chance to cut you off because you've already done some good to them. And at home, when someone in the family says something hurtful, it's more than just holding your tongue. It is responding with a kind word of love. It's human nature to get revenge, to hurt the one that hurts you, human nature. But all that does is build walls, each side adding one brick after another. It doesn't accomplish anything. And sometimes what we need to do is to stop and think about how we can stop building walls and build bridges to other people, to reach out to other people, to love them. Treating others the way that you want to be treated. That's how you build bridges. That's how you live the Christian life. And it's not easy. And I know it's not easy, and you know it's not easy. But being a disciple of Christ, it's never easy. But it's the only way to live life abundantly. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And now unto God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be ascribed all might, power, dominion, and glory. Today and forever, amen.
Like the woman at the well, I was seeking for things that could not satisfy. And then I heard my Savior speaking, draw from my well that never shall run dry.
My cup, Lord, I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up.
But none can match the wondrous treasure that I find in Jesus Christ my Lord.
Fill my cup, Lord, I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul.
Away. My blessed Lord will come and save you if you kneel to Him and humbly pray.
Fill my cup, Lord, I lift it up, Lord. Thirsting of my soul, bread of heaven, feed
with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right that we should at all times and all places give thanks to you, Almighty God. And we join our voices with choirs of angels who forever sing to the glory of your holy name. We give thanks to you, O Lord, that on the night of his arrest, Jesus took bread, and in the same way he took the cup, and he instituted this, the Lord's Supper. Remembering your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we take from your creation this bread and this wine, and joyfully celebrate his dying and rising as we await the day of his coming. With thanksgiving, we offer our very selves to you to be living and holy sacrifices dedicated to your service. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and wine, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the communion of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. On the night of our Lord's arrest, he met with his disciples. And after supper, he took the bread and broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." I invite you now to take a piece of the bread that you have prepared and to receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ. And in the same way, after supper, he took the cup and he said, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood. Whenever you drink it remembering me." And now I invite you to take the cup that you have prepared and to receive the cup of Christ. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we are unworthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you're the same Lord who always shows mercy. And in your mercy, you have allowed us to come, and more than that, you have invited and urged us to receive these gifts. Empower us now by your Holy Spirit that we may go into the world to declare your love to all people. In the name of Christ we pray, amen.
A spark to get a fire going, and soon all those around can warm up in its glowing. That's how it is with God's love. Once you've experienced it, you spread his love to everyone. You want to pass it on. What a wondrous time is spring, when all the trees are budding. The birds begin to sing, start their blooming. That's how it is with God's love. Once you've experienced it, you want to sing. It's fresh like spring. I'll shout it from the mountain top. I want the world to know the Lord of love has come to me. I want to pass it on.
Go in peace and serve the Lord. Amen.
Find a solace there.